Aloha and welcome. Sound Journey Saturday. Ka'imi and I are going to lead you guys on a journey. Invitation, as always, is to find a comfortable place to be where you don't have to move for the next hour-ish. Is Helena joining us? No. Good speakers are awesome. If you don't have good speakers, headphones are better, unless of course you're in the room, in which case I encourage you to keep your ears open. And my queen likes to remind us to bring an intention to this. There's a lot of energy that gets moved with the sound of the gongs and the bowls moving through and stimulating your interstitial tissues. That energy becomes available for you to use, and having an intention can be an awesome thing. We'll go for about an hour. It'll get loud, it'll get soft, it'll get loud, it'll get soft, then it'll get silent. In those moments of silence, I encourage you to focus in on your body, how you're feeling, if there's anything going on for you. Know that as the energy moves through you, if it finds blockages, you might experience a little muscle twitch or a little tension, and that's perfectly expected and okay. The key to working with that is to use your breath to breathe through those areas of tension or uncomfortableness and allow those blockages, encourage those blockages to clear. It's part of why we're here. This is why this is a healing sound journey. When it gets really quiet, again, follow the breath. Take a peek into what your body's doing. See if you feel different before and after is sometimes a good plan. I'll play the rav drum for a few minutes after that, and then I'll leave it quiet for a couple of minutes probably, and then I'll talk you back. So when it gets to the quiet moments, just hang tight. If you're in this room especially. If you're done with this and you're watching this in the remix or live, feel free to leave whenever you're ready. Oh, and if you are watching it on a remix on YouTube, smash that like button. And hit subscribe if you'd like to know when we post new ones. Anything else I can think about that I need to say? You look absolutely lovely. I love this on you. What is that? Yes. Okay. Ka'imi and I will breathe three times together. While we do so, we ground into Mama Gaia. For me, that means growing roots. That sets up an energetic pathway for anything that's done, anything I'm done with. That energy has done its job, perhaps. That's why it's stuck. And if you breathe it out and let it go and give it to those roots, Mama Gaia will take it in. She'll transmute it. Maybe she'll offer it straight back up into you. If not, maybe someone else in the morphogenic field is ready for good, cleaned up, filtered energy. Grounding, intention,
breath.
We did that. We're going to breathe. Yeah, and we'll talk about water when it's over. So, see you in an hour. Hello.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
as the last of these sound waves waft off into the universe. Taking our prayers and intentions with them. The invitation is to find your breath. And allow the finding of that breath to bring your consciousness home. And finding yourself reintegrating with this physical form, you may find the desire to wiggle your extremities, flexing hands and fingers, wiggling your toes. Allowing the simple joy that you can move to burst upon your consciousness. Powerful times in the celestial playgrounds these days. Full moon, lunar eclipse. All kinds of spatial anomalies happening. What a great time to be alive. And conscious and paying attention. If you're in the digital world, make sure you drink plenty of water over the next few days. Sometimes these vibrations shake loose things that are better floated out than allowed to settle back in. Water will help with that, and it's just really a good idea. Blessings. See you again.